हेलो चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एट होम. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट चैप्टर 8, इंडिया, क्लाइमेट, वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ. इन दैट आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग द क्लाइमेट इन इंडिया. सो देयर आर फोर मेन फैक्टर्स दैट डिटरमाइन द क्लाइमेट ऑफ अ प्लेस, एंड दीज आर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सी, अल्टीट्यूड, लैटिट्यूड एंड रिलीफ. Okay, children, in this class we are going to learn types of natural vegetation in India. So before starting this lesson, let's learn some good habits. Children, yesterday I told you about that we all should avoid junk food because it is very injurious for our health. So in place of the junk food, we all should have a balanced diet with proper nutrients. So this girl, she is eating up chapatis, pulses, rice, vegetables, including fruits. So we all should have a proper diet every day. Now let's turn to our topic. So today's topic is natural vegetation in India. Children, the trees and plants that grow in an area without human interference make up the natural vegetation of a plant place. So we see a variety of plant life in our surroundings. How nice it is to play in a field with green grasses. There are also small plants called bushes and shrubs like cactus and flowering plants, etc. So besides, there are many tall trees, some with many branches and leaves like neem tree, mango, or some which stand with few leaves such as palms. Okay, children. So the grasses, shrubs and trees which grow on their own without interference or help from human beings are called natural vegetation. Do you wonder, children, how these differ from each other? Different types of natural vegetation are dependent on different climatic conditions, among which the amount of rainfall is very important. So due to varied climatic conditions, in India has a wide range of natural vegetation. And you know, children, forests are very useful for us. They perform various functions. Plants release oxygen that we breathe and absorb carbon dioxide. The roots of the plants bind the soil, thus they control soil erosion. And forests provide us with timber for furniture, fuel, wood, fodder, medicinal plants and herbs like honey, gum, etc. They provide us many things. So children, we all should plant trees every year. Okay, children. So forests are the natural habitat of wildlife also, and natural vegetation has been destroyed to a large extent because of the reckless cutting of trees. We should plant more trees and protect the existing ones and make people aware of the importance of trees. We can have special programs like Van Mahotsav to involve more people in making our earth clean and green. Okay, children. So here India has 5 main types of natural vegetation: tropical rainforest, tropical deciduous forest, thorny bushes, mountain vegetation or montane forest, and mangrove forest. Okay, children. So then first I'm telling you tropical rainforest. These forests get their name because they grow in tropical areas around the equator that receive high rainfall. They grow in areas that have an average temperature about 30 degree centigrade. Next is tropical deciduous forest. These forests also grow in tropical areas around the equator, but at higher latitudes than rainforest. They grow in areas that receive moderate rainfall. एंड थर्ड थॉर्नी बुशेस, दे ग्रो इन ड्राई एरियाज वेयर द अमाउंट ऑफ रेनफॉल इज वेरी लो. वेजिटेशन इन ड्राई एरियाज टेंड्स टू हैव थॉर्न्स इंस्टेड ऑफ लीव्स टू प्रिवेंट वाटर लॉस ड्यू टू इवेपोरेशन. नेक्स्ट इज माउंटेन फॉरेस्ट और माउंटेन फॉरेस्ट. दीज फॉरेस्ट गेट दियर नेम बिकॉज दे ग्रो इन माउंटेनियस रीजन्स एट वेरी हाई अल्टीट्यूड्स एंड द टेम्परेचर इन दीज रीजन्स इज क्वाइट लो. एंड मंग्रोव फॉरेस्ट, दीज फॉरेस्ट ग्रो इन रीजन्स दैट आर एक्सट्रीमली हॉट एंड ह्यूमिड एंड रिसीव वेरी हैवी रेनफॉल. दे गेट दियर नेम फ्रॉम द मैंग्रोव ट्रीज फाउंड इन देम. Okay, children. So now revise this concept. Read the chapter from your book and try to complete question answers related to this concept. Till then, thank you and have a great day.